Secretary of State Hillary Clinton was hospitalized yesterday after doctors discovered she had a blood clot. Few details of her condition were initially released, but late today, her doctors said the clot was located in a vein between her skull and brain. They stressed she did not suffer a stroke and is making excellent progress. Dr. Gholam Motamedi, a neurologist at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital, is here to walk us through the known risks and treatments for blood clots. And I guess, doctor, to start at the very beginning, what is a blood clot?
Yeah, blood normally has the tendency to coagulate or clot. If you take the blood out of the system, out of the circulatory system, it will clot. If you are, let's say, in a laying down in a hospital, typically in a hospitalized patient, without movement, blood has the tendency to form clots. And sometimes under abnormal pathologic circumstances, there are medical conditions that make you more susceptible to have your blood clot, and from cancers to chemotherapy agents to infections and so forth. But in good number of patients, there is no specific cause detected. But in this particular case, again, it's difficult to tell since we don't know many details. But typically, we see that in patients who are pregnant or just deliver the baby, and a series of conditions that make you more susceptible to blood.
Well, in the last few hours, we found out a little bit more about the Secretary of State's condition and the location of the clot. A blood vessel in the back of the head, close to the ear. How does a clot get there? What happens inside the body for it to form?
Right. It could be blood most likely was formed in that area. It's not always transferred. Yes, it's true that you can have blood clot formed in your leg, for example, and then a small piece of it is dislodged and then joins the bloodstream and is carried to the lung, brain, heart, and so forth. But in cases of transverse sinus, probably because of that tendency to form a blood clot or hypercoagulability or slow movement, slow flow of blood, the blood is clotted in that area and then, if not treated, can expand in that area and cause other problems. But why this happens, again, since we have to speculate, it could be, first of all, we hope it's not related to any malignancy, which is one of the conditions. We know pregnancy or giving birth is not the case. In some patients who are smoker and are on birth control pills, again, there's a tendency to form that blood clot.
Well, but in the case of Mrs. Clinton, we know that during an earlier illness, she became lightheaded, fainted, and then hit her head and concussed. Could it be a side effect of the concussion?
Concussion in adult actually is not a known cause of sinus thrombosis, venous sinus thrombosis. In children, head trauma sometimes makes them susceptible. And besides, given that it's a very uncommon condition, roughly about 5 in 1,000,000, it's not a common condition at all. So I doubt it was directly related to concussion because in general, it's not known to be caused by that. But among possible causes, again, if you're allowed to speculate, it would be, we ruled out some of them, like pregnancy, or if there is any tendency, blood disorder, a tendency to to a condition called hypercoagulability.
So what do we do in treatment, and is it a long course of treatment?
Yes and no. If there is, for example, in someone who's pregnant or just gave birth and they have developed this sinus thrombosis, about 3 to 6 months of anticoagulation or using blood thinner would be enough. If there is no particular cause, it may range from 6 to 12 months, and there are conditions when it's unlimited. So to some extent, it depends on what other underlying causes we have.
Once you put someone on blood thinners, do they have any other contraindications? Are there things they should be careful of, activities they should avoid? Are you at risk for other things once you're on an anticoagulant?
Yes, in fact, we don't start it if there is any high risk for bleeding, for example, if someone had a surgery and so forth. But when you are on blood thinner, which is actually constitutes a large number of population for different reasons, many people are on Coumadin blood thinner. When you are on it, you have to be just cautious not to induce bleeding because you'll tend to bleed. That's the purpose of using blood thinner. But otherwise, we can have more or less normal life. It's not as bad as it sounds, but of course you have to be cautious.
Dr. Gholam Motamedi, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.